What is going on, everyone? Welcome to Road to Platinum series on Color Guardians. This is a free PS Plus game on the PlayStation Store December 2016. So I'll be going through the first 10 levels of the game, and this is the castle stage. And basically at the very beginning, I want to knock off a lot of the easy trophies that you can do within the first 10 levels. And also, once you complete all 10 levels, you can actually go back and replay them to find these hidden sort of fairy looking things. So I'm going to be showing you all the locations of those fairy looking things, and it'll basically unlock a secret path with different levels. I'm gonna explain lots of the trophies as I go along. I did play all 10 levels with 3 stars. I didn't show it because some of the recordings got messed up and I had to re-record the footage. And so I recorded the screenshot of me getting the trophies, and I'll basically be placing them where I got it and explain some of the methods I used to get some of them. So far, this game is particularly simple. You just have to, be quick in your timing and reaction, and you should be easily getting all 3 orbs, all the orbs for the level. So I'll get into more detail, and you can look at the description below for the specific trophies that you are looking for. And all of these 10 levels, I will be showcasing the Toki location of those fairy things. So in this first tutorial level, what I'm doing is, without pressing circle to continue the conversation, you can actually spam the square, triangle, and X button to spin. And once you spin 215 times, you get party like it's 2015. I will be showing 2 more runs of this tutorial level. One is getting a 3 star, which is a trophy you get called Well Done. It's basically your first time getting 3 stars. And then I'm going to show you another tutorial run, which is showing the fairy location. So this is the tutorial run for finding the Toki or the fairy looking thing that's floating around hidden in this level. And basically you just want to stick to the very bottom, don't collect any orbs, don't bother with it. You want to have a low score because we're going to knock off two more trophies in this run. The first one being, you know, not achieving any star level. And the other one is to only collect multicolor orbs. So don't collect any of the red ones, the blue ones, and the yellow ones, only collect multicolored orbs. And if you stay at the very bottom, I think that's basically how I got it. I actually didn't look at this trophy and I just got it, so that was kind of lucky. Moving on to level 3, you can do this on any level, but I just chose this one when I was replaying it. So you'll see the Toki location for this, as well as I'm not gonna enter any of the checkpoints. So at the end of this, if you don't use any checkpoints, you'll get a trophy for doing that. Thank you. at this point of the game, I just want to showcase Colorama and Lolly 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 Lollipop. So Colorama is collecting 2,000 orbs of any color, and Lolly Lollipop is collecting 100 of those, I think the big orbs, or the multicolor orbs. And this will came this will definitely come naturally when you're playing, and you know, within this first 10 levels. So at the end of this level, this is where I collected all the 10 Tokis. That's why I got this trophy. I actually did the level 6 to 10 first before I did level 1 to 5. Because, you know, my recording was messed up from level 6 onward, so I had to replay those. And I figured I might as well like showcase all of the Toki locations all at once. So Castle Seeker is a silver trophy for getting all of the secret hidden Tokis in all 10 levels. So as you can see at the start of this level, I started spinning everything. You basically want to just spam that, you know, color button for the entire time for this entire level. And if you spin them like this, you'll get a perfect spin every time if you just spam that button. And at the end of this level, if you get everything perfect, then you will get the trophy for, I think, put a ring on it, which is a diamond star for the level. Also, at the same time, you'll want to keep doing this throughout the game. It could be done in the first few levels, or I started at level 6. After you do, I think, like 200 something spins or something like that, then you also get another trophy, which is like diamond glitter or something like that, which I will show in the next level. Alright, so at the beginning of level 8, this is where we see the water. So if you don't choose the red, if you don't press square and you are the yellow guy or the blue guy, you can actually just fall into the water. And if you fall into the water 3 times in a row, you get a trophy. And I didn't show it here, but basically at the very beginning, you can just change to a different color other than red. Just fall in 3 times, and then you get a trophy. I'll show you the screenshot at the end of this level. There is a trophy for completing a speedrun without any deaths and collecting all the orbs, and this video will show you exactly that. So as part of level 10, after you hit the checkpoint here, there is one group of orbs that are really hard to miss, which is that one. So once you hit that mushroom, make sure you tap down twice. So, and change to the yellow one just so you can hit that one. That was the tricky one that I missed when I was playing this level. Alright, so now we fight the boss after completing all 10 levels, and at the end of this, you get a trophy for defeating him, just like all the plot trophies in various games. After defeating a boss, you usually get a trophy. So right now you saw I died. If you are struggling with this in terms of, you know, reaction time and stuff, because I always press the wrong button when I react to it, what you can do is just stay as one color and you can just keep waiting until, you know, he fires the right ball at you. So you can just worry about dodging rather than, you know, changing color at the right time, and then just press circle and throw it right back at him. I got really lucky here. He's basically threw three red balls at me and I was red the entire time. So hope you guys enjoy watching this video. I hope the content was clear, and lots of support and feedback will be appreciated, because I did put a lot of effort into making this video. The next video would be, you know, level the second world, levels 1 to 10, and again it will be all the Tokis and trophies with it. Hope you guys enjoyed the video, and don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe if you haven't already, and stay tuned for the next episode. Bye everyone!